It's 1 p.m. Let me start our lecture. There are three problems for chapter 4 homeworks, and the due date is on the examination day. That is, if I correct, September 20. Okay, that's mean next Tuesday, about a week from now. And let me start to the point that the inference line diagram for the statistically determined different from statistically indeterminate, based upon what we know about Moore's law principle. When we know no matter the beam is statically determinate or statically determinate, the principle for drawing the inference line diagram is the same. If you like to draw the inference line of R sub A, your very first step, you got to release what? Release R-E-A-S-E. It release the resistance of what you have. Let for this one, you release the resistance of R sub A. What it mean is you just change the support pin over here, okay? And when you release the resistance to R sub A, that mean you got to change the pin into the roller like this. Why you release this? You release this because you are looking for the deformation of the beam. That's why you release this. เราออกเพราะว่าต้องการให้คานมัน change the shape. And then for the second step, you apply the R sub A. When you apply the R sub A to the beam, what going on? The beam will deform. Okay. Deform to what? Deform to the shape like this. For example, if you take the projector like this, you release the resistance, okay, at point A. You move the point A for 1 unit. The shape of this ruler is going to be the shape of the inference line diagram. So when you move this one up for 1.0 unit, the shape of the beam is the inference line diagram of R sub A. And then the coordinate of this inference line will determine from the deflection at point X when the force applied at point A, divided by the deflection at point A when the force applied point A. So at this point is the point A, okay? It's going to be F sub AA divided by F sub AA. It's going to be 1.0. How about point B? At point B, you know, the deflection over there is zero. Why? Why the deflection over here is zero? Because at point B, it's the roller. So zero divided by F sub AA is zero. And the last one, when you move to point C, the deflection over there also zero. So you have zero over here. When you connect 1.0 with zero, you're supposed to get the deflected curve of the beam. Now, if you move to draw the inference line of V sub D, you release the resistance of V sub D. What you release the resistance of V sub D, typically the beam has the resistance to both what? The shear and the moment. When you cut any portion of the beam, you cut positive V downwards on the left, and upward on the right. When you release this, that means there is no resistance to the shear force. That means over here, you just put the roller guide over here. When you put the roller guide over here, you also put the positive shear. One is downward and another one is going to be upward. What you get for the downward in this side, for the upward in this side. And see, for the upward, the shape of the deflection very close to R sub A. What I mean is, if you copy over here to draw the picture, you got the same shape of the deflected curve on the right portion. On the left portion, the beam gonna move curve upward. Why? Because even though you release the resistance by the roller guide, the roller guide still has the ability to resist for the moment. So the tangential line between these two lines, they must be in parallel. That is the obligation. Okay, first, the relative displacement is 1.0. Second, the tangential line over there, they are in parallel. Okay, and then you will get the equation to determine the coordinate of the inference line. It's going to be F sub XD when the shear force applied D, divided by the deflection at point D due to the shear force at point D. So for this second, do this second inference line, again, you must determine the deflection. And then you must determine the deflection. So one of the method to draw the inference line diagram, to draw, not to draft, okay, to draw, you got to know the coordinate. The coordinate come from the conjugate beam. You got to go back and review your conjugate beam method for this. Next, if you like to draw the inference line diagram of the moment, now you got to release the resistance to the moment. To release the resistance to the moment M sub D, you got to put what? This one? The hinge over there. Okay. Before that, you put the roller guide. And let me put it over here at pi V sub D Fiat 1. For this one, you got to apply M sub D. And then what we have is the M sub D will move the beam up like this. And then you get the shape of the beam to be what the inference line diagram of M sub D. And if you're not sure, this one just concave upward. You can specify it, even though you cannot draw it clearly, okay? And you got to be very sure that this one also concave upward, the same as this one. Why? Because the moment applied downwards like this, bent this side to be curved like this, and the other side curved like this. Make it for sure. And one obligation for this is the relative angle between the tangential line of these two portions must be 1.0. And then you can determine the coordinate of the inference line of M sub E by the deflection at point X due to the moment applied at point E, divided by the slope at point E due to the moment applied at point E. Okay, and then I will ask you guys to put the loading pattern into the inference line ได้ครับ so the first problem on the third term examination you got to draft the inference line diagram you got to write the inference line diagram equation and then compare between the positive and negative area and if you do some demonstration for example for r sub a you may compare the area under the curve which one is larger the one that near the apply force or the one that also near apply moment this one the positive gonna have very large area compared to the negative area so the influence of this portion will be larger than the other one and it is positive so if you have the uniformly distributed life load you got to put kit like this and if you has the uniformly distributed load dead load the dead load always distribute all over the beam so if you have the dead load always full span full length of the beam okay how about if you have concentrated force life load or FLL or PLL or point load life load in the form of point load you got to put it in the point of the maximum coordinate okay that's in 1.0 over here the same thing when you compare for this one this portion has larger area than this portion and the largest or highest coordinate is here so the loading pattern for the m sub e will be like this again for the dead load is always full span but for the uniformly distributed life load is going to cover only for the positive larger area okay the harder problem come to the shear when the shear you divide it at the half length most of the time the negative and positive will have very cross equal area by this shape so you got to use the third portion to control it for this one the negative will provide a larger effect so the uniformly distributed life load must put in this one okay and also if you have the point load since the negative area has the larger effect so the point load must be put over here okay and then not only this one you also have a lot of type actually you have many types of beam and a lot of problem but I can classify the drafting of the inference line diagram into three types first you have pin and roller or it's maybe roller and pin and the span may be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 okay the largest span that I will make the examination will be 6 the smallest I will have only 2 span so the number of span will in between 2 to 6 and then I may change this one to fix and another portion roller or I may put it in the opposite direction just keep this one the same and change another side to be the fixed. Okay, that is going to be the second type. And how about third type? The third type just make fix. So again, it can be pin roller. It can be fix. It can be roller fix, or it can be fix roller. That is the main three types of it. And I like you guys go back and review what we have from the previous lecture. This example cover nearly all of the required reaction, shear force, and bending moment on this kind of problem, okay? And then for the loading pattern, you got to consider positive influence or negative influence. Which one going to be larger? You pick the larger one and put the loading pattern, okay? And then the ACI use this kind of concept to what? To develop the moment coefficient, or also the shear coefficient that can be used in the design of the beam basis upon the ACI design code. That means you don't need to do structural analysis. You may pick up the coefficient of the moment, the coefficient of the shear, and do the design. Okay, I won't come to this detail of the ACI moment and shear force coefficient must be discussed by one of your ajahn in RC design. And the second problem for the drafting of the inference line diagram, let us consider the smallest span, supposed to be 2, okay? Again, the last just supposed to be 6. And now I put this side to be the fixed support. And the author is going to be pin or roller. It's going to make the same effect in the deformation of the beam. Let's start by the inference line of G sub Y. Okay, that is going to be F sub XG divided by F sub GG. Again, I'm come to what I show you guys from the previous example. In the previous example, if I have 2 span, this is going to be the defected curve. Okay, but now you change this point into the fig. So only small things change. You can see at my thumb, only the deflection change into another shape. This is for the pin support. This is for the fig support. Okay, they are small different. And then when you dock it, you may make it larger. Let's put it like this. Let's put it to be concave downward and put another portion into the concave upward. But by this time, you must put it in a larger scale. So you can see this one is concave upward. Okay, and this black one is concave downward. You understand what I'm saying, right? Okay, and then if we like to draw the inference line of D sub Y, now that is going to be F sub XD divided by F sub DD. Now, if you have again your ruler or your projector, you just keep this one like this, and then you put it at the middle. If the left and the right is the pin and roller, the shape will be like this. Take a look at this, please. The shape will be like this. But since this one is fixed, the shape will be something like this. See, on my left hand, if it's pin, it's like this. If it's fixed, it's gonna be something like this. So you may again the this one, this is fixed, and then this one supposed to be, let me put it in lighter blue. This one is going to be up, concave upward, and then it's going to concave downward like this. And this one will move for 1.0 unit. And I should say the drawing that Ajahn Thongsak make it is not that good. Just take this one, okay, out. And the deflection supposed to be the light blue light over there. That is going to be a little bit clearer than before. And then we come to the inference line of A sub Y. That is going to be the deflection at point X due to the force applied at A divided by the deflection at point A due to the force applied at point A. So by doing this, you got to release the resistance to the reaction. And then you got to be really differentiate between the shear and the reaction. If you draw the inference line for the shear, you must put the light blue arrow into the problem. But this one you didn't. You only like to determine the inference line of R of A sub Y. You just put the A sub Y upward. Lift this one for one unit. That means over here when you dock it, you will have only one A sub Y force. And then this portion must keep the right angle. Why? You just change it to the roller guide. The roller guide still have the resistance to the moment. That's why over here it must be in normal angle or perpendicular angle. And then what we have is this one. If you just draw A sub Y from the previous example, this one from the previous example. For this one, since this one is fixed, see? The picture will change to something like this. Over here, change to here, to keep it in the normal angle, okay? So you got to have two portion of the deflected curve. One is concave downward, and the other portion will concave upward, okay? And then for the loading pattern, you can see this loading pattern will provide the maximum G sub Y. For the D sub Y, you got to put the load, the whole two span of the beam to obtain the maximum D sub Y. For the maximum A sub Y, you guys must put the load like this to provide the maximum A sub Y. These three figures show us that they are all different. The loading pattern will different for the different effects, for the reaction at G, reaction at D, and reaction at A, okay? The loading pattern all are different. And then coming to the moment at A, when you draw the moment at A, the D and the G, still the roller, you got to first release the resistance to the moment at A. When you release the moment at A, that means over here, it still be able to taking care of the shear. And next, you apply the moment over here and over here. The moment on the left provide nothing because that moment apply to the wall. However, the light moment will bend the structure with the angle of one unit, and then the defected curve, you just bring your ruler, you will see the shape like this. And based upon what you see, the area over here, negative area will be larger than the positive area. So the loading pattern that produce the maximum M sub A will similar to the one that produce maximum R sub A. Okay, and then this one will be F sub X when the moment apply at A divided by alpha at point A due to the moment apply at point A. Okay, and next we come to the inference line of moment at point H. For the equation, the deflection at point X when the moment apply at point H divided by the angle at point H when the moment apply at point H. Based upon this, for what? You must release the resistance to the moment at point H, put the hinge into it, and then you apply what? You apply the moment, this one will lift up. It's going to be very the same as the previous one, except when you consider the portion that connect to the fix, this one need to concave downward. The other portion concave upward. Let me put it in the green one. This one will concave upward. Okay, and then you will have this area positive larger than this area. So for the moment M sub H, you must put the loading in this shape to get the maximum M sub H. See, you like to have M sub A, you got to put the load in one pattern. For the M sub H, you got to put it in another pattern. Okay, and then that is the first problem of the third examination. The question will ask you to draft the inference line diagram for reaction, for shear, and for the bending moment. Second, okay, the problem will ask you to write the equation for the inference line of reaction of the shear and of the bending moment. The third portion of the first problem will ask you to put the loading pattern, okay, that produce the maximum effect. Again, the dead load always cover the whole length of the beam. However, for the uniformly live load, the length of the load will proportion or will basis on the inference, will basis on the area of the inference line, which one is larger. How about the point load? If you got the point load, you got to put it at the point of maximum coordinate. For example, for M sub A, if you like to put it, you may see you got to put the point load at this point. Why? Because this point has the maximum coordinate. Okay, how about this one? The point load, you got to put it over here because the coordinate over here is the largest. How about the other thing? Let's see, over here the point load must put over here. Over here the point load must put above here. Okay, and over here the point load must put above here. Point load put at the point of the maximum coordinate. uniformly distributed load put in the area of the largest area under the inference line diagram. And then the second problem. For the second problem, I will ask you to compute the defection, and then you plug that defection into the inference line equation. We have discussed about this already, but let me review it again. If you like to draw the inference line diagram of reaction at point A, okay? What you do is, by the definition, by the Boosler-Baseler, you got to take this support out, and then you apply the R sub A at this point. Again, why you take the support out? You take it out because you like it to be free, okay? When you apply the reaction, that point will move. When that point move, the beam will deflected, and the shape of the deflected beam is the shape of the inference line diagram. So based upon this, you just change the A sub I to be one, and then based upon this, this one will be the deflection at point A due to the loading at point A. This one will be the deflection at point D due to the load at point D. Okay. This one will be zero. This one will be the deflection at point D due to the load at point A. And this one will be zero deflection at point C due to the load at point A. This is zero deflection at point B due to the load at point A. It is zero. So by Muller-Baseler, we have the shape of the deflected curve like this. But if you guys like to draw the inference line diagram, you got to follow the equation. By following the equation, what you get is you got to use what's so called the conjugate beam, the method of virtual work, to compute all of this deflection. And then you got to divide the deflection. For example, over here, you divide it by F sub AA. For this one, you divide it by F sub AA. Now, this one is going to be inference line of A sub Y. If you divide all of the point by F sub AA, this one is going to be the deflected beam, okay? Before you get the coordinate. Again, it is a requirement to determine the value of the deflection at any point X. Now, let me move to what we have from our previous discussion. We had the example that we find the reaction at point A. Let me move you back to the previous lecture. I forget something. It must be somewhere here. Okay. This is supposed to be here. Okay. Okay. Let's us move to this example. From the not this one for your group must be something else. Okay. From this one, from the previous lecture, let me take you back. We like to draw the inference line of the reaction R sub A. Because the last example that we have together, and then what we have is we change the pin into the roller, and we keep the roller here and the roller here the same, and then we apply the R sub A and move the beam. We will have the deflected beam like this. Okay, and the shape of this beam is the shape of the inference line diagram of R sub A. That's the first thing. The second thing, if we like to determine the coordinate of this inference line, we must follow the inference line equation. The inference line equation of the R sub A is what? Is equal to the deflection at point X due to the applied load applied at point A divided by the deflection at point A due to the load applied at point A. The problem is, since this one is R sub A, we cannot compute for the deflection. So we got to change this R sub A into 1.0 unit. Let me draw another picture to make it clearer. So what we do is, let me put this one into beside here, and then basis up on this one. When you change the R sub A into 1.0, again, this one, don't worry, it's still be here. And what we have is this one is point A. This is going to be the deflection at point A due to the loading at point A. Okay, and then we also have the same shape. But by this time, what we have is we need to specify the X, and then over here, this one will be the deflection, at point X due to the loading at point A. Okay, and by setting X starting from here, so 0 less than or equal X, and the X can be moved until reaching the point B. So it's going to be less than or equal 10. So this one, X will move from A to B. Now, if we come to another portion, this portion BC will have the inference line shape that's different from this one. So in computation, you got to put another coordinate. Let's say X1. Now X1 will be from C to B, and 0 less than or equal to X1. X1 equal to less than to 10. Okay, and the deflection we have over here is F at X1. Okay, X1, F at X1. When the load apply at point A, see, this two are different. And if you like to draw the inference line diagram, what you do is you got to draw the same thing, but now you got to divide it by F sub AA. So basis upon what we know, this one will be 1.0 because it's going to be f sub aa divided by f sub aa. Okay, this one and this one, don't worry, this f sub at b and apply force at a is zero. Zero divide anything, this is zero. The coordinate of this point. Now you got to divide it. This one will be f sub x a divided by f sub a a. And for this one, this one is going to be f sub x one a divided by f sub a a. The shape of the inference line will be the same, but the coordinate will follow the inference line diagram equation. The problem is, under this one, we got to determine the deflection. There are two coordinates, so you got to determine the deflection by two x1 and, sorry, x and x1. And again, come to this Max Müller's Bayes' law principle. We draw this one. Under the application of 1.0 unit, we can determine R sub B and R sub C. So based upon that, we may take, for example, summation of the moment at point C equal to zero. So what we have is R sub B rotate in this way. So 10 R sub B. This one rotate in another opposite one. So 1 times 20. So based on this, you got 20 divided by 10. You got R sub B equal to 2. Okay. And then summation of F sub Y equal to 0. What we have is R sub C upward. This one is upward. So R sub C plus 1 equal to 2. So R sub C equal to 1. Now, when you get this reaction, you come to this portion. Let me take this one out of the of the monitor. So based on this, this one is upward. When you draw the shear diagram, this one upward 1.0. There is no W. The slope is zero. When you reaching this point, the 2 take this one minus 2 plus 1 is minus 1. And again, there is no W. Slope is 0. You get this one for the shear diagram. Now, you move to the moment diagram on the left and on the right. They pin and roller. So the moment here is 0. The moment here is 0. What you have is the slope of the moment diagram is going to equal to the shear. So the slope is 1. And then moment here minus 0 is going to be equal to this area. So it is 10. And when you move here, the slope is minus 1. You get this one is 0. Okay. And then you got to determine the deflection basis on the conjugate beam. By the conjugate beam, what you do is you got to change this one, the actual beam, into the conjugate beam. And since this one is released, okay, it's maybe free. So when you change it into the conjugate beam, what you get is this free to fix. Actually, it's not really free, but we just imagine there is no roller over here because for the shear, sorry, for the beam, no axial force. This one actually you can just neglect it. Okay, to make it easy for convert it into the conjugate beam. So free change to fix internal roller change to internal hinge. External roller keep it. Okay, and change the point from A to A palm, from B to B palm, from C to C palm. The moment diagram, you must divide it by flexural stiffness, and it's changed to what's so called elastic weight. Now, the problem is there is the reaction, there also the reaction over here. Over here, there is C sub Y palm, okay? And then what we need to do, not here, we got to compute the reaction. Let's say this one is going to be C sub Y palm, and this one, since the support is fixed, you got to have this one M sub A palm, and you also have this one A sub Y palm. The problem is we cannot compute the C sub Y palm directly from this free body diagram. Okay, even though you take the moment at A palm, you have M sub A palm and C sub Y as the unknown. So it's better, let me hook up this way, separate this beam into two portions, and let me draw the free body diagram of the beam like this one. This is for B palm and C palm. Now, you have this one for 10 over EI. What we are looking for is going to be this one, C sub Y palm and B sub Y palm. This is 10 meter. If you like to determine which one, let's take the moment summation of M sub B palm equal to zero. C sub Y palm will rotate in this direction. And you may see C sub Y palm times 10, rotate in this way, rotate this way. But this one, you have 1/2 of 10 and 10 over EI. That is gonna be 50 over EI. This one will equal to 50 over EI times this length, that is going to be 10 over 3 and 10 and 10. So your C sub Y palm is going to be 50 over 3 EI. Okay. And then summation of F sub Y equal to 0. Downward is positive. B sub Y palm. B sub Y palm. B sub Y palm is going to be equal to B sub Y palm. Actually, plus 50 over 3 EI. And then it's going to be equal to this one, 50 over EI. Now, your B sub Y palm is going to be this one, change to 150 divided by T over EI. So this one will be 100 over 3 over EI. This one will be 100 over 3 over EI. Now for the second portion, this one will apply here. 100 divided 3 EI. And it also has the elastic weight like this. And then this portion is A sub Y palm. And this one for the M sub A palm. Okay, and this one is 10 meter, 10 over EI. If you do the summation of F sub Y equal to zero, that one is positive. So A sub Y palm, this one is upward, equal to 100 over 3 EI. And this one has the resultant to be 1/2 of 10 and 10 over EI, the same as over here, 50 over EI. You plus 50 over EI, okay? And if you times it by 3, this one will be 150 divided by 3 EI. So you get this one to be 250 divided by 3 EI, okay? Life is so busy. And next, I will show you guys about the score, and I will tell you if you still not focus to what I'm showing you, you know, you cannot do it by yourself at your home. I'm guiding you to be able to pass it, okay? And if you not follow the guiding, you'll still be here. Only one way you may have another chance is you find graduation. And after we check, if you get F, next term you find graduation, and for sure you may graduate. We will offer you the course like last year, but there is no teaching. You got to watch the video, and then you got to take examination. And then if you cannot pass on the third third term, even though you are going to graduate, we won't offer. So some of you guys, I will show you the name later. Beware about it, okay? We can help, but we cannot help you all the time. You got to help yourself. This is important, okay? So focus, even though it's so boring or it's not nice to study, but try to be so, at least trying to be a civil engineer, okay? Most of the civil engineers on this world, they're passing this kind of thing. Not pass this one, they may pass moment distribution, or they may pass slope deflection, whatsoever. If you won't pass all of them, just pass a few. I mean, not few, a few. Few is not enough. A few is enough, okay, to pass the dog. But few, you won't pass it. You still sinking in this pool of structural analysis. So go ahead, on this one, you got to have this one. So next, M sub A palm is equal to zero. We are looking for it. Clockwise direction is positive. So M sub A palm is going to be equal to 100 divided by 3 EI. And this one is 10 meter, just times 10. And then this one in the opposite direction, like this one, 50 over EI. The distance between here and here is gonna be 2 times 10 divided by 3. So it's gonna be 20 divided by 3. This is going to be 1,000 divided by 3 plus this one is 1,000. So it's going to be 2,000 divided by 3 EI. And you know that from the conjugate beam, the moment is going to be the deflection. And this is the moment at point A due to the force applied at point A. So this one will be F sub AA, guys, and this one will be the divider of this equation. Now, we get the F sub AA already. Next, we will determine the
F sub XA and F sub X1A. Okay, now I take this one out and I move you guys again to this point. And by this point, we going to determine the moment M palm. The moment M palm that's show here is going to be what? It's going to be the deflection over here. Since, as we know, the equation for the portion AB different from the portion BC. So we need to draw the free body diagram of these two portions. And what we have from the previous one, I'm not sure. Let me go back to this one. Okay. Some of you may have kids, but some may not, but it's okay. Let me take you over here. From this free body diagram, we're looking for the moment here. So we take the moment at this point, and then the M palm rotate in this direction, counterclockwise, is positive. And what we have is, it must be plus by this one. This one from the previous discussion, we have it to be 250 divided by TI. You may do the calculation and you will get it for 83.333. And this is time X, they rotate in the same direction. So plus, in the opposite direction, this moment is 2000 divided by 3EI. You put this one, and this one is one half of this one, W. If you use the similar the angle, the value of W is here. So one half time X and time W. And over here to here is just X over 3. You get this equation. And if you divide this equation by what we have over here, you will get the equation for the inference line of this first portion. Okay. And then we move to another portion. After we do a lot of calculation, okay, this is the equation for this portion. You got this one. And then from the previous lecture, this one, oops, move here, F sub XA and divided by F sub AA, this one. You divide this one is F sub AA. This one is F sub XA. You got this. And then we don't have much time from the previous one. Let me do it again for this portion. Okay, we like to find this moment. We do the summation of the moment at this point to be zero. And then this M palm rotate in this direction is positive. C sub Y palm. Now you put it into a digit. Okay. And then you're going to take over here plus 16.667 divided by EI. Now it's time the distance X1. And there is again the resultant force one half of W that we have X1 over EI time X1. And the distance from here to here is X1 over 3. So the M palm, which is equivalent to the F sub X1 when the force applied at A, is going to be this one, X1 1 cube over 6 minus 16.667 x 1. This is EI divided by EI. Okay. And in the form like this, you can go again in fence line of this one is R sub A. Let's say for coordinate x1 is going to be equal to this one x1 cube over 6 EI minus 16.667 x1 over EI. And then for F sub AA, you have this one 667 and then EI. EI just take EI, okay? And then you have x1 cube divided by 6 times 666667 minus 16.667 x1 divided by 666.667. And then following this, what you guys has is rearrange it. You supposed to take this one up. Actually, if you take this one up, you multiply this one. This one supposed to get to be 4,000, right? 6 times 66.667. This 4,000, right? It's like x1 cube over 4,000 minus this one. If you times it 6 by 6, it's going to be 4,000. And this one times 6 is supposed to be 100. Okay, and then you get the equation, this one, x1. You get the equation over here. Okay, and then what we have is, in conclusion, by doing this, we get the inference like equation of this one in the form like this. Of this one in the form like this, and they have the that put the coordinate over here. If you put 0 over here, this one will be 0, this one will be 0. It's going to be 4,000 divided by 4,000 is 1.0. If you put 5 over here, you put 5 over here, you will get 4,000 minus 2,500 plus 125 divided by 4,000. You're supposed to get this value, okay? But for this one, it's 0. On this side, if you put 0 over here, that is 0, that is 0. You got 0. If you put 5 into this equation, you get this coordinate, okay? Now, let me move it a little bit to the next one. On the next one from this equation, you get the question like this. Sometimes, Ajahn will provide you with the equation. Not sometimes in the examination. The first portion, let's see this one. I provide you this equation. If I said, if this one is 10 meter, this one is 10 meter, you have this one to be 4 times 10 cubed. That is 4,000 minus 500 times 10 square, 500 x and plus x cube. Okay, so you're going to get the same equation as before, and you may divide this one again by 4 times 1,000. So that is 4,000. And for this portion, again, you put it as before, the L square is 10 square. So this one will be equal to minus 100 plus x1 cube and divided by 4 times 1,000. So let again, Ajahn provide you with the equation and you can determine the equation. Follow the loading that Ajahn provide you guys in this area. This problem asks you something from the obtained inference line diagram of the reaction R sub A. They ask you to find the reaction. What you're going to do to finding the reaction? Now, you go back to inference line diagram in the theory of structure. The R sub A in this one will be equal to the given load, 2 kilonewton per meter. And it's going to have the area of inference line of R sub A. Okay, this one between A to B. And based on this, it means what? It means we are looking for the area, okay, of the inference line diagram that's cover the uniformly distributed load. This one has no distributed load, so you don't need to consider it. So you have 2 kilonewton per meter, and then you got to integrate this equation from A to B, integrate from 0 to 10 of 4,000. If you have the calculator, please use your calculator to integrate it. If you don't want to use this, it's okay. Okay, but 4,000 baht calculator can do this calculation. And then what you get is going to be 2 times the integration. You're supposed to get it 4.375. This one, 4.375. And you get this one to be 8.75 kilonewton. So what it mean? What it mean for this one? It mean that following the loading, you can compute for, let's see, the reaction. Not here. It's okay. Oops. I switch this one with my solution. Okay, don't worry. What I mean is now you get 8.75. So this one will be 8.75 kilonewton. And then what you do is, what is going to be R sub B? And what is going to be R sub C? Now you can do the summation of the moment at point C to be 0. You got to determine R sub B. R sub B over here times 10. R sub B times 10. plus 8.75 times 20. They rotate in the counterclockwise direction. And then there is the resultant force here. That is going to be 2 times 10 is 20. The distance between the 10-20 kilonewton to point C is going to be 15. So this one will be 20 times 15. So when you put it into your calculator, you get R sub B equal to 12.5 kilonewton. This is going to be 12.5 kilonewton. And then if you do the summation of F sub Y equal to 0, R sub C is downward, R sub C downward plus 20 is downward equal to 12.5 plus 8.75. By doing this, you will get R sub C to be 1.25 kilonewton. This one is 1.25 kilonewton. And now you are ready to go further toward to the shear diagram and moment diagram of this beam. Okay, you may do it by yourself. We are going back to engine static. Okay, and then let me move you guys a little bit back to the problem, this one. If now we have only the point load, this one has point load, based upon what we have for this one, the inference line diagram of the R sub B, you have two equations as before, and this one for what? For just switch this one for X, this one for the clean. Okay, this one for this portion. Based upon now the point load, we can do the same thing. They ask us to what? To find the reaction R sub B. Previously, we find the reaction R sub A, right? But this one for the R sub B. And let's see, R sub B for this one is going to be 10 kilonewton, and it's going to time the coordinate of inference line of R sub B at D. Now we're going to do the computation. That is going to be 10 kilonewton time what? Time this equation 300. Since this is the point over here, that is 5 meters. So 300 times 5 minus 5 cubed, and then you divide it by 2000. So this cut. And if you put it, you will get this R sub B equal to equal to what? I lost track on this. Okay. 6.875. So this is going to be 0.6875. Oop, no. It's going to time 10. Sorry. No, time 10. So this is R sub B equal to 6.875 kilonewton. Now, what is mean for this one? Since this one get the positive, you get this one for 6.875 kilonewton. Okay, and then You do again. You just determine the R sub C and the R sub A. You do the same thing. Summation of the moment at point C equal to zero. Rotate. This one is positive. R sub A times 20 and plus 6.875 and time this one time 10 and this is in the opposite. So 10 time what? Time 15. Now you do the calculation. You supposed to get R sub A equal to 4.0625 kilonewton. Okay. Or you may say, I like to have only 4.06 kilonewton. And then you do the summation of F sub Y equal to zero. You will get R sub C. R sub C downward plus 10. And then it's going to equal to 4.0625 and plus 6.875, the R sub C supposed to be 0.9375 kilonewton. Again, you can draw the shear diagram and moment diagram and please try to work on yourself because we don't have much time on this. Okay. Now, let's tell you what the most important thing that Ajahn like to tell you is the related to the examination. Let me recall you again from the start of this lecture. Okay, we're talking about how to draft the inference line diagram based on Muller-Wiesler principle. Okay, and then I tell you about the equation of the inference line. And on the first problem, the third portion, how we put the live load onto the draft inference line. That is the first one. The second one, actually, in short, I will provide you with this inference line. It's maybe this one, the inference line for R sub A. And then I ask you guys for a given loading pattern. From this one, the loading pattern can be point load. If the point load, you just time the point load with the coordinate, you will get the reaction, okay, for this problem. And then you determine the author reactions and draw shear diagram and moment diagram. The detail of this can be found in the PowerPoint, the PDF file that I provide you, okay? And then what else may we have for another one that I show you guys? I also will provide you with this one. Okay, this one. Again, the equation. And then I ask you for the uniformly distributed load. And then you find the reaction for R sub A for this one. And use the free body diagram. Which one? We diagram. To determine the author reactions and then draw the shear diagram, moment diagram. This is the second type of the problem, or this is the second problem. The third problem will be like this. The third problem, I will ask you to find the equation of the inference line. That's for sure. The third problem is supposed to be what's so called a lot of requirement from you to work on it. is maybe the R sub A, I already show you, or is also maybe for R sub B, this one for R sub B, or is maybe R sub C. Okay, and then from this inference line, is maybe R sub A or R sub B. I will further ask you, as you may see in what we have for the problem F. We will use that to determine the inference line of shear and inference line of the moment. Okay, and let me start for a quick look. This is up on this one, inference line of R sub B. We also can use the free body diagram and equation of equilibrium to determine the equation of the inference line of R sub A. What I'm saying is, from this one, we can find this one by this one. In conclusion, R sub A can come from the conjugate beam, as I show you. And what I'm going to show you, the R sub A also come from this one. How to find the equation of R sub A basis upon this? Again, we come to our free body diagram. Let us start by knowing this. Knowing the inference line equation of R sub B. And we will use this information to determine the inference line equation of R sub A. Let the loading apply to this one at the reference X. Okay, and then what is mean from this one, if the load is in this green area, okay, the equation over here, R sub B, is going to be this equation equal to 300x minus x cubed divided by 2000. And then we can determine the R sub A by taking the moment at point C. And there is another one. When the 1.0, let me put it in another color. When 1.0 is over here, now the R sub B is going to be this one basis on X1. Okay, so this one will be 300 X1 minus X1 cubed over this one is going to be this equation over 2000. And again, we are looking for R sub A. By the concept of this, we just take the moment at point C, summation at the moment at point C equal to zero. Let me put for X, okay, from A to B. This one, X from A to B. Or let me put it in, this is green light when it's moved in this one. for x from a to b, and then what we have is take moment at point C. R sub a is our subject, so counterclockwise is positive. R sub a times 20, and then we plus R sub b times 10, okay, and it's going to be equal to 1 times 20 minus x, 1 times 20 minus x. So what we have is 20 R sub a will be equal to 20 minus x and minus 10 times R sub b. This is going to be 300x minus x cubed divided by 2000. So what we have is we just put this one, take this one, and this one will be 20 times 200 minus x times 200, okay, and then minus 300x minus x cubed and divided by 200, and this is R sub a. This 200 will times 20. You take 20 down here. So what you get is going to be this one is 4000 minus this one is this one 500x minus x cubed and then divide by 4000. You get the same equation as previously we have. Where is it? Where is it? Oh, it's going to be this one. This one is going to be the same as this one. Okay. Say this one. And then let me move you guys to the next summation for x1 from C to B. M sub C equal to 0. Take moment here. And counterclockwise is positive. R sub A now times 20. And then plus R sub B times this one times 10. And then it's going to be equal to this one, 1 times x1. And again, 20 R sub A equal to x1 minus 10. This equation come 300 x1 minus x1 cubed and divided by 2000. And again, if you cut this one, this is 200. And you get this one, 200 x1 minus 300 x1 minus x1 cubed and divided by 200. Now you consider only R sub A, so this 20 is down, and then you get this one minus 100 x1 minus x1 cubed. This is negative. Negative. This one must be positive. Okay. And this one must be positive. And then this one for B, 4000. What we get is the equation here, and the equation here, they are the same equation. This one for I cannot zoom it. This one for the green. This one, and this one also for this one. What I'm saying is, from this example, the inference line R sub A can come from two ways. One, this one R sub A come from known R sub B. Okay, and also this one R sub A come from the conjugate beam and Musler Basler principle. Okay. Anyway, let me move a little bit more. Now we are at the point to determine the inference line of R sub C from what? From the equation over here. Okay, what we have over here is we are trying to determine the inference line of R sub C. The inference line of R sub C is what? Let me take you back. We got to release this one and take this one for R sub C and move it for 1 unit. Let me put it to 1 centimeter. And then this is going to be the inference line of R sub C. Okay, and this one is 1.0. Inference line of R sub C can come two way. One, come by the conjugate beam and Musler-Basler principle. Or it may come by what? By free body diagram and the equation of equilibrium of the known R sub A and R sub B. Let me put it. If we just only know R sub B, you don't need to know everything. Just know R sub B is more than enough to determine R sub C. Or if you know R sub A, you also can determine R sub C. Okay. It's going to be like this. Let me work on we know R sub B. Okay. If we know R sub B again, this is going to be R sub B when the load is 1.0 with reference to X as before. This is going to be 300 X and minus X cubed over 2000, and there now we are looking for R sub C here. Let me zoom it in. Okay, and actually we also know this one, the R sub A is going to be equal to what we have over here, 4000 minus 500x and plus x cubed over 4000. Okay, this is the free body diagram of the beam based upon the coordinate x. And if we put it over here 1.0, and now the coordinate is x1. What we have is this one R sub B equal to 300 x1 minus x1 cube divided by 2000. However, the equation of R sub A must be this one for this one. R sub A equal to minus 100 x1 plus x1 cube and divided by 4000. Okay. And then again, this is going to be our subject of R sub C. Okay. The very simplest way, let me use this set first to determine R sub C. If I like to use R sub A to find R sub C, I got to take the moment at point B equal to zero. Okay. And what I get is R sub C rotate in this direction. R sub C time 10. R C time 10. And then this one plus one time this one, time what? 10 minus x. So 1 times 10 minus x. And now this one, I got R sub A time 10 also. So 10 R sub C will be equal to R sub A, this one, for 1000 minus 500 plus x cubed divided by 4000 times 10. And this one will be minus 10 and plus x. Now you cut this one, cut this one. You get this one to be 4000 minus 500x plus x cubed. This one to be minus 4000 plus 400x. And then you divide this one by 400 and take R sub C. And this one 10. Now this one cut, cut. This one and this one, you get minus 100x. Okay, and this one you plus x cubed and divided by 4000. So this R sub C going to be in this portion. Okay, and then what next? We move to this one. We summation of the moment at point B equal to zero. Now R sub C, this one, R sub C time 10. And then this one in the opposite direction equal to one time, this one is 10 minus x1, 10 minus x1 time 1.0. And this one rotate R sub A time 10. Now we have 10 R sub C equal to 10 minus x1 plus, we use this one, 10 time 1 minus 100 x1 plus x1 cubed divided by 4000. And then cut this one, cut this one. This one equal to 400 times 10 and minus 400 times x1, 400 times x1. And then you have this one minus 100 x1 plus plus x1 cube, and this is 400. When you put this one to be r sub c, this also take 10 over here. And then what we have is this one 4000, this one minus 500x1 and plus x1 cube divided by 4000. You get this equation. This equation will be this one. And if you go to over here, you can see R sub A and R sub C just in the opposite, just switch equation, okay? Okay, up until now, what I'm saying is you must derive the inference line of R sub A, R sub B, and R sub C based upon conjugate beam and Muller's principle. Okay, first thing. One of them, I will ask you for sure, one of them. And then I will ask you, this is going to be the third problem, Rocco. This is going to be the toughest one. And then I will ask next to determine the inference line of another reaction. Usually I will ask you the inference line of the shear force, or I will ask you to determine the inference line of moment. For example, we come to this problem. Use again the free body diagram and the equation of equilibrium to what? This one, to determine the equation of the inference line of V sub BL. Of what? Of M sub V. As I mentioned, we will not use the conjugate beam and Muller-Bessler principle to find the equation of the inference line of the shear force, of the inference line of the bending moment. Anyone who is interested in that, you can read from the textbook or in my lecture note. Okay. But after you find the inference line of reaction, you may use that inference line to compute it again. You also may be used the same way, inference line of reaction to determine inference line of V sub D and M sub D. This is supposed to be our next lecture, okay? Okay, that is going to be our next lecture, and that is going to be very, again, comprehensive. What I'm so called, really comprehensive. For today, I supposed to finish my lecture over here, and this is for. Oh, okay. This is for problem B. You may go to find your shear diagram and moment diagram if you prefer, like this. I think I already take the picture of this problem and post all of the problem into the Facebook already, right? Do so. Anyway, please check